joining, it's going to be nuts.
Yeah. Now, if it's a smaller con than Otakon, usually they're cons in hotels. You're probably going to want a room in that hotel because then you can keep going back to it all the time and you can do all sorts of crazy stuff.
At the same time, you can cram more people into the room because a lot of people are probably going to spend all night hanging out in the con.
Yep. And, you know, like at Otakon, you pretty much had to leave the con, go back to your hotel and sleep at night.
Yep.
For the cons with the hotel room in the con, usually your hotel room turns into a party room at night. There isn't a lot of sleeping going on. It just turns into like a stuffed storage bin. So you don't need to get as big a room when you have something like that.
Yep. Though if you actually want to throw a party in your room, like not just people are hanging out, but we are having a party.
Public,
we're gonna
you know, with public admittance.
We're going to do a separate bit on that another day because we've done it many times and we can tell you exactly how to do it. And let me just say that it is not for the faint of hearted.
Yeah.
It is not easy. It is not trivial. You will get screwed, but it might be fun anyway.
You have to get the biggest room you can.
Yeah, and you have to expect to spend money, and you have to be the kind of person who has no trouble lying through their teeth to a police officer.
Mm-hmm. Now, so to get a hotel room, figure out the best hotel, proximity and price. Figure out how many rooms you're going to need. Make sure you call well enough in advance, you know, for the con, because the hotels will be sold out for big cons.
I mean, Otakon, three of the hotels are already sold out.
For what, August?
Yes, for this coming August.
That's 8 months away.
In fact, two of the hotels sold out within 2 weeks of the con ending last summer.
So it's 12 months prior. Yeah, great.
There were people calling hotels at the con for the next year. I'm not kidding.
So, get them well enough in advance. Make sure that you call the hotel, let's say you order the room 4 months in advance. Call them 2 months later to make sure and confirm the rooms. Then call them the week before the con and confirm the rooms.
Yes, and even then, when you get there, check in and confirm what you're getting. Because mm-hmm. remember when I said that when we showed up 3 hours before our friends and we checked in, the hotel was a disaster?
Mm-hmm.
We checked in, and they gave us the key to our room. Now, we had ordered a giant suite because we had like 12 people
coming. With an upstairs and a downstairs.
Yes, this hotel room has 2 stories inside of it, and it had like these Utena windows. It was awesome. So we go to our room, and we open it, and it's just a tiny little room.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell? So we go back to the front desk, and we're like, all right, bitches, we ordered a suite. And they're all, yeah, suite sold out. We're dumb. And we're like, great.
They ended up giving us...
they gave us the guest suite, like the presidential whatever suite, for a discount. And they worked it out with us because we were a large group of angry people who was going to raise hell.
Yep.
But I'll warn you that if something like that screws up, the hotel is not obligated to serve you in any way.
Mm-hmm.
Hotels are not obligated to keep your reservation. So keep on them and make sure you've got it.
Yeah, basically be an ass to the hotel and keep pushing them and pushing them to make sure that what you have is right. And there should be someone in your group who's the designated hotel doing person, which is probably the most responsible person.
Now, make sure, one, that that person has a credit card, because you have to secure the room.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have multiple rooms, you have to secure them all separately. And we actually have to split that between two of us, because I only had one credit card, and because of various things on it, it could only secure one room at a time.
Mm.
Because they reserve a lot of money on your card to reserve a room.
Yep.
Because they're worried about breakage and such.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as for paying for the room, basically, there are two ways to look at this. We trust our close friends completely, so we don't make them pay like right away at all, whatever. We just trust that they'll give us the money, and they all give us the money. If there is any shadow of a doubt whatsoever, and even if they're close friends, make them pay in advance, either before you book the room in cash, or make them pay before you let them into the room.
Mm-hmm.
Because if someone's unreliable and they don't pay you right away, they're never going to pay you.
And you'll just end up having to pay like hundreds of dollars for this hotel room and someone else stayed in it for free on your bill. And that's not
good.
Yeah,
be wary of people who just say they might come and then they show up and they want a place to crash. Because that means they don't want to pay you anything, but they want to use your shower and bed.
Yeah.
Now, we've never actually had this happen, but a lot of our friends have, so this is just kind of a warning to, even though you might all be friends, work out the money ahead of time, mm-hmm. because it's real easy to lose friends over stupid things like money.
Yep, so, checking in, you get to the hotel, you go right to the desk, you say you want to check in, you get your keys, you go to your room, you put your stuff in it. You make sure that, you know, you keep count of people in the room. You keep track of those keys. Holy crap, you keep track of those keys.
Yes. If the wrong people have your keys, they'll disappear and you can't get into the room and you're fucked.
Make sure that whoever actually paid for the room, the hotel person, who, you know, whoever's in the most responsible guy, he's got to have a key, whoever it is. You know,
two?
Or she.
Usually, you might think, oh, I'll give the key to the two most responsible people. Or the two people who are, like, running the event. That's always me and Scott.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's kind of stupid for both of us to have keys because we're both usually together at the con.
Mm-hmm.
Great. So, make sure you spread the keys out in a way that will inconvenience the key holders the least.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if someone is a diabetic or someone has asthma or someone has a reason to go to the room often, they should have a key.
Mm-hmm. And let's say there's like three people that are pretty much going to hang out with each other at the con. Give one of those three people a key. The most responsible of the three people a key. You know, because, you know, they'll probably be going back to the room together. And, you know, if they're not going to split up, then why give them two keys?
Now, we used to have a lot of stuff to say about, like, radios or how to keep in touch with people or rendezvous points. But honestly, that's made completely moot by cell phones.
Cell phones and Nintendo DSs pretty much eliminate any need for that.
Yeah, everyone we knew had a cell phone, and we all just call each other.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the one drawback of that is that, at least for us, pretty much my phone rang about every 15 minutes for the entire convention.
Mm.
I just set it to mute, and then I'd look, and like 10 people have called me, trying to get into the room, or trying to find out when we're going to eat dinner, or telling me that they found something cool,
mm-hmm.
or... Yeah, that's just my rant. That's not actually anything useful.
I get just about as many calls at cons, just from other people at the con all over the place doing stuff. Where are you? Let's meet up and eat. Oh my God, you have to come to this event. You know, this is going on. Do you want to do this? Oh, I saw something crazy. You know,
well, I guess the warning there is that if you want to be the people like us, the ones who organize this for your group of friends, because someone has to do it or you're going to have drama, be wary that your friends, while they're your friends, will become energy leeches and will draw all of your energy, efforts, and attention for much of the con managing them.
It's a good thing that most of the time the conventions are loud and I can't hear my phone ring.
Yes.
So I don't pick it up, not because I don't want to, but because I really don't hear it sometimes at the con, which I guess is good, you know, because then I pick it up later and I go, oh, someone called, whatever, you know, and usually it's not super important. And if it is, they'll call again and again.
Now, we went real long, so we're going to wrap this up for now. But we're going to start up, this is going to be a series every Thursday until we finish this.
I think we might finish it next week. We're going to talk about what to do actually when you're at the con.
Yep. I'm also, next week, I want to talk about specifically how to cram a lot of people in a hotel room without getting kicked out and without having a problem.
Because
there's a lot of info there.
Yep.
All right. So stay tuned next week. Tell us your funny con stories. We'll probably play them if they're funny enough.
And have fun if you're going to any convention soon. I think the next con I'm going to is probably going to be the New York City Comic Con in the Javits Center in February.
Yep, and I'm going to be at KatsuCon, and I may or may not be on a panel. And if I'm not on a panel, I have a friend who's definitely going to be on a panel.
All right, awesome.
And that was Geek Nights with Rim and Scott. Special thanks to DJ Pretzel for the opening music.
Thanks for listening. Please remember to point your favorite podcatcher at feeds.feedburner.com/geeknights to get the latest episodes as soon as they're released. Also, please visit our website at www.frontrowcrew.com for the latest updates and forum discussion. And whether you love or hate our podcast, we won't know unless you send your feedback to us at geeknights@gmail.com.